Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Hi students, today's topic is very interesting: goodwill, valuation and treatment of goodwill on admission of a partner. So that's what we are going to discuss today in detail. What does goodwill mean? Yes, it means a lot of things. It means good reputation of the business, the import licenses the business is enjoying, the market conditions of the business. If a business is a monopoly situation, it will enjoy good reputation, and all these reputation and efficiency of the management, location, customer relationship, there are so many factors that affecting the value of goodwill. Now, ultimately, what I want to emphasize is that all this must result into super profit earning ability of a business. So goodwill is nothing but the ability of a business to earn super profits. Now, what does super profits mean? It will mean the profits earned by the business is more than the similar concerns, and this will have some effect on the business. The business will be able to retain the present customers. The customers will come again and again and enjoy the products, they buy the products, they even recommend the products to others. Okay, so it will attract new customers. This happens easily. You can identify when you watch a good movie. You enjoy that movie and even you will advertise without receiving anything. You will advertise, you will recommend that movie to your friends. So the present customers will even advertise for the business and they will bring in new, more customers. This will create the super profit earning ability of the business. Now, when do we have to revalue goodwill? The valuation for goodwill arises in these situations: when there is a sale of business, when there is reconstitution of the partnership firm. Do you remember what is reconstitution? Yes, it happens on admission, retirement of partner, death of partner, insolvency of partner, even mere change in the profit and loss sharing ratio, there is a reconstitution. Okay, it is nothing but a change in the agreement. So dissolution of partnership firm also warrants the need for valuation of goodwill. When there is amalgamation of firms, goodwill must be valued. So these are the different situations, and we are going to specifically concentrate on good valuation of goodwill on admission of a partner. Valuation of goodwill on admission of a partner should be done because the new partner will now enjoy super profitability without any efforts. A new partner is entering the firm and he is able to enjoy more profits than similar concerns, the super profit. Who made this super profit earning ability of the business? Who worked on the reputation? Who worked on the brand? Who worked on the location? Who saw that the business is having an efficient management? Who got all the import license or all special advantages of the business? It is the old partners, the existing partners. Now they are going to lose a share of their super profits. So they should be compensated. It is very natural. So the old partners must be compensated. For this purpose, the new partner must bring in an additional amount towards goodwill, which is called premium. So the new partner must bring in an additional amount or premium, and this should be distributed among the old partners in their sacrifice ratio. So this is why we need to value goodwill. Now the valuation of goodwill, how do we do it? Goodwill is an intangible asset. It's not like a furniture or machinery or land, building, which are tangible assets, which are very easy to value, revalue. Okay, but goodwill is intangible. I cannot see it, you can't see it. Okay, no one can see it. Only we can experience the goodwill in a business. How? With the super profit earning ability of a business. So goodwill valuation becomes estimation. We are going to estimate goodwill using certain methods like average profit method, super profit method, capitalization method. So we will apply certain methods and we will value goodwill, and these are estimates. These are not actual valuation like a tangible asset. Okay, tangible assets can be easily valued. For example, if you want to know the value of a furniture, you can find out how much material, wood is used, what is the cost of the wood, so many cubic feet. Okay, how many carpenters have to work on that? So the wages of the carpenters, and what are the other expenses needed? You can add all this and you can say this much would be the exact cost of the furniture. That's not the case with an intangible asset like goodwill. Now, when I say goodwill is an intangible asset, please remember it is not fictitious. Fictitious assets are different from intangible assets. Intangible assets enjoy value. You can sell goodwill. You can sell goodwill at the time of sale of the business, of course. Okay, you cannot sell goodwill partly. You can sell goodwill at the time of disposing the firm. Okay, if you are selling your firm to another person, goodwill can be sold. You can get a value for that. Goodwill has a value, whereas fictitious assets don't have any value. So please remember, goodwill is an intangible asset. It has a value, and you will do the estimation of goodwill or valuation of goodwill using these methods. What are these methods? Average profit method, super profit method, and capitalization method. At Goa Board, you will have to solve problems based on average profit method and super profit method. So we will be solving problems based on these two methods. Under average profit method, you are considering goodwill equivalent to average profits of the business multiplied by a number of years purchases. Okay, so how do you find the average profits? Average profit is nothing but the total profits of certain number of years. 3 years or 5 years of profit, you add up together, then you get the total profit divided by the number of years. If you are adding 3 years profits, you will divide it by number 3. If you are adding 5 years of profits, you will divide it by number 5. So you will get the average profit, and this average profit is multiplied with a number of years purchases. It can be 1 year purchases, 2 years purchases, 3 years purchases, and so on. So we will value goodwill on the basis of average profit method using this formula. Let us look at this question. Read carefully. The profit for 5 years are as follows. You are given 2015, 16, 17, 18, and 19. So you are given the profits for 5 years. Okay, you may be given profits of 5 years, 6 years, but you have to read the question carefully. Calculate goodwill of the firm on the basis of 4 years purchases. So we have to multiply with 4 years purchases of 5 years average profits. Yes, we have to consider 5 years profits to find the average. So how do we calculate it? The total profits. How do we get the total profit? You will add all the profits, 4 lakh, plus 398,000 plus 450,000 plus 445,000 and also 500,000. So this is the total profits. So all this you should add up, you will get the total profit and divide by number of years. How many years we have considered? We have considered 5 years. So you are going to get the average profit now. And this average profit you will multiply with the number 4. It is given 4 years purchases. So you are going to get 21,93,000 by 5, 4,38,600. So the average is 4,38,600 multiplied by 4, you are getting 17,54,400. So this is the value of goodwill. Now this is the value of goodwill of the firm, of the business. When the new partner is admitted, he has to contribute new partner's share. If he is having 1/4 share, you will find out 1/4 of this amount. And that's the amount the new partner has to contribute. Now sometimes, instead of simple average profit method, we may calculate weighted average profit method. And this method must be used when there is a tendency of increasing or decreasing trend in the profits of the firm. So in this case, what we do? The profits of the firm, for example, the profits are say 20,000 for the first year. Okay, second year it became 30,000. And third year it became say 50,000. So there is a tendency of increasing profit. These profits will be multiplied by certain weight. Okay, which will be given to you, which will be given. The weight is say 1 for the first year, second year it is 2, and third year it is 3. So you will find out the weighted profits. Weighted profit of the first year will be 20,000 itself. Second year it will be 60,000. And third year it will be 1,50,000. So you will get 1,50,000 plus 60, 210, 2,30,000. So this 2,30,000 is the weighted profit. Okay, now this weighted profit, you will find average of that. How do we find average? By dividing by the total weight. 1 plus 2 plus 3, the total weight is 6. So you will do 2,30,000. Divided by 6, then you will get the average profit. 2,30,000 divided by 6, you will get the average profit. It is going to be 38,333.33, like that it will go. And this will be multiplied by number of years purchases, number of years purchases. Okay, so this is how you are going to get. So the profit will be multiplied with the weight and you will find the weighted profit. And this weighted profit will be divided by the total weights. Then you get the weighted average profit, which is multiplied by number of years purchases. So it is similar to the average profit method. Now let us go to the super profit method of calculating goodwill. Super profit method of calculating goodwill. Here, we know that goodwill is the ability of a business to create super profits. What exactly is super profit? It is nothing but the excess of actual profit over and above the normal profit of a business. Okay, every business will have certain normal rate of return, which is called NRR, normal rate of return. So this NRR is the expected profit or estimated profit or normal profit a business is expecting. Suppose if it is a 10% and the investment is a 3 lakh. So the business is investing at 10% on 3 lakh, that means 30,000 rupees. But if the actual profit earned by the business arrived from the profit and loss account is say 70,000, so actual profit is more than the expected profit or estimated profit, which is considered as the super profit. So super profit is calculated using this formula. Actual profit, it can be the actual profit of 1 year, or it can be average of last few years profits, and from this we minus the expected profit or estimated profit, then you get the super profit. Now this super profit is calculated, the estimated profit is calculated, as I explained, on the capital employed. You have to multiply with a normal rate of return, then you will get it. Then you will find out the goodwill. Okay, goodwill is super profit multiplied by number of years purchases. Let us take up a question and see how to calculate super profit. The books of a business showed that the firm's capital employed, so you will notice that capital employed is given on 31st December 2020 is rupees 5 lakh. So 5 lakh is the capital employed by the business. Profits of the last 5 years are given: 40,000, 50,000, 55,000, 70,000 and 85,000. So you are given the profits of last 5 years, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the question? You are required to find out the value of goodwill based on 5 years average profits, considering 3 years purchases of the super profits of the business. Okay, we have to find out the goodwill on the basis of super profits of the business, considering 5 years average. Okay, very good. What is the normal rate of return? What is the NRR of the business? Normal rate of return is 10%. So we will calculate the normal profit or expected profit and minus it from the actual profit or average profit. So what would be the estimated profit? Capital employed is 5 lakh. On 5 lakh, 10% is the estimated profit, and you get 50,000. This 50,000 you have to minus from the average profit. So let us take up the average profit. The average profit will be 40,000 plus 50,000 plus 55,000 plus 70,000 plus 85,000. So when you add all this, you are getting 3 lakh, and divided by number of years, 5, so you will get 60,000. Correct? This is the average profit, 60,000 minus. What is the estimated or normal profit or expected profit? It is calculated on capital employed. Capital employed is 5 lakh. Normal rate of return is 10%. So on 5 lakh, 10% is 50,000. That means we are expecting only 50,000 profit. But actual average profit is 60,000. So here, this will mean that there is a super profit of 10,000 rupees. Now this super profit, you have to multiply by number of years. How many years? 3 years purchases. Okay, so let us multiply with 3 years purchases, then we get the goodwill of the firm. So goodwill of the firm on the basis of super profits is 30,000 rupees. And this is the goodwill of the firm. The new partner will have to bring not 30,000, his share of goodwill. If his share is 1/5, so he has to bring 30,000 into 1/5, and so on. That we will see when we solve the problems. Now sometimes the goodwill may appear in the balance sheet. So we will see what to do with the goodwill appearing in the balance sheet. If goodwill appears in the balance sheet, it is called existing goodwill. Goodwill existing in the books of the firm. And this account of asset must be written off at the time of admission of a partner. How do we write off an asset? An asset has a debit balance. When we write it off, it should be cancelled by crediting. So we are going to credit a goodwill account, and the amount should be taken from the capital account of the old partners. So the old partners' capital account will be debited in their old ratio, and the goodwill account will be cancelled by crediting. So this is what we have to do when we solve a problem. If you are given this in the capital accounts of the partners, suppose there are three partners, A, B and C, and these are the capital accounts, you will have to debit capital account and write it to goodwill. The amount should be debited to the account of partner A and partner B, assuming that the partner C is a new partner. So this is how the goodwill account written off if it already appears in the books of the firm. So we learned the valuation of goodwill. Now let us learn how to treat the goodwill account on admission of a partner. On admission of a partner, there can be two situations. One, the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash. And secondly, the new partner is not able to bring his share of goodwill in cash. So when you read the adjustments, you have to be very careful to see whether it is specifically given that the new partner is bringing his share of goodwill in cash or not, because the solution will differ according to the instructions given there. Now, if the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash, there can be two situations. A, the amount is retained by the partners. Amount is retained by the partners. Or it can be partially withdrawn by the partners or fully withdrawn by the partners. So there are two situations. If the new partner is bringing his share of goodwill to the firm, whatever amount he is bringing, the old partners will share it and they will credit their capital accounts. After crediting, they can prefer to retain the amount in the business, or they can withdraw the amount fully or partially. So let us see how to solve problems based on this. We will begin with the journal entries. When new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash, it is called premium method. Why it is premium method? Because the amount brought in by the new partner is what we mean by premium. The amount brought in by the new partner towards goodwill is what we mean by premium. So premium method refers to the new partner bringing in his share of goodwill amount in cash by check also. You can have two methods. We will discuss the method one first. This is most commonly followed method. So when the new partner brings cash for goodwill, cash or bank account will be debited, debit what comes in, okay, and goodwill account will be credited. So the entry for cash brought in by the new partner towards goodwill is cash or bank account debtor, because it's an asset. Goodwill also is an asset. That much part of the asset will become of the new partner. Okay, so it is moving out of the business. So cash or bank account debtor to goodwill account. Now this amount brought in by the new partner should be distributed among the old partners. Okay, so the old partners will take out this amount brought in by the new partner. What will happen to the old partner's capital account? It will of course increase. Increase in capital, increase in liability is a credit. Okay, so you have to credit the capital accounts of the partners. And when goodwill is distributed among the partners, this account of credit account in the goodwill will be cancelled. Now we are going to debit the goodwill account and cancel it. So goodwill account was credited, and now we will cancel it by crediting it. So the journal entry is goodwill account debtor to old partners capital account. Now, it's very important to remember, capital accounts of the old partners must be credited in their ratio of sacrifice. The sacrifice made towards the new partner. Okay, in that proportion, we will credit the capital accounts of the old partners. So, it's very important, old partners' capital accounts will be credited with the premium in the ratio of their sacrifice. So, this is a very important point. Please note it. Now, if the partners prefer to retain the amount, there is no entry, nothing is going out of the business, no cash is taken. On the other hand, if partners prefer to withdraw the amount, they may withdraw full amount, they may withdraw part of the amount, okay, then the cash or bank will be credited, that much cash goes out of the business. Bank balance decreases, so there is a decrease in the bank balance or cash or bank account is credited, so you are going to credit cash or bank account. Partners are the receivers, they are withdrawing money from the business, so their account, capital account will be debited, debit the receiver. Debit the receiver, that's the rule we are following. So partners' capital account will be debited and cash or bank account will be credited. So this is how we record the entries when a new partner brings in cash towards his share in goodwill. Now, there is also another method. In this method, when the new partner brings in cash towards goodwill, it is directly credited to his capital account. On the other hand, in the first method, we credited to the goodwill account. So, instead of crediting to goodwill account, partner may prefer to keep it in his account. And his account will be debited. New partner's account will be debited when it is shared among the old partners. So, the old partner's capital accounts will be credited in the sacrifice ratio, but the debit will go to new partner's capital account. Why? Because the amount of goodwill was credited in the capital account of the new partner. So, only these two accounts are different. Otherwise, everything is the same in the method 1 and method 2. You may follow the method 1 or method 2 as per the instructions given in the question paper. We will see certain examples. Sunil and Dalip are partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:3. So you will note down, this is the old ratio of Sunil and Dalip. Sachin is the new partner admitted in the firm for 1/5 share. So 1/5 share of profits is the new partner's share. He brings 4,000 as his share of goodwill. So 4,000 is 1/5 of the total goodwill. It is given directly as his share of goodwill. We will take the 4,000 directly as he is bringing it by check. Show how these transactions would appear in the books of accounts. So we learned the journal entries. Now we will see how the entries are to be posted. When the new partner brings a premium of 4,000, what is the entry we learned? Bank account debtor to goodwill account. So bank account debtor to goodwill account, it will be shown in the bank account as an increase. Bank account increase because we are debiting the bank account with 4,000 rupees. Okay, bank account debtor to goodwill, and it will be shown in the goodwill account. I have not shown the goodwill account here. Now, this goodwill must be distributed among the old partners in their sacrifice ratio. So, what is the entry for that? Goodwill account debtor to old partners' capital accounts in their sacrifice ratio. So, the old partners' capital accounts must be credited by goodwill in their sacrifice ratio. So 4,000 we have to divide in the sacrifice ratio. What is the sacrifice ratio? It's not given in the question. You have learned sacrifice ratio is equal to, okay, old share minus new share, or old ratio minus new ratio. Whenever the new ratio is not specifically given, It is not given the new ratio of all the partners. You will consider sacrifice ratio equal to the new old ratio. So here the sacrifice ratio is the same as old ratio. So you will divide 4000 in the 5:3 proportion. So 4000 multiplied by 5/8 will be 2500. 4000 multiplied by 3/8 is 1500. So it is distributed and given to the old partners, and in this question they are retaining it because it's not given that they are withdrawing. So this is how the goodwill appears in the capital accounts and also in the balance sheet. We are showing balance sheet, asset side bank account, and an addition of the premium brought in by the new partner, 4000, so it is added to the bank account. If you are preparing the bank account, you will show it on the debit side to new partners, to goodwill account, you will show on the debit side. Let us take up this question. Sunil and Dalip are partners in a firm, sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:3. This is the same old ratio. Sachin is admitted in the firm for 1/5 share. So Sachin is the new partner and this is the share of the new partner. The new partner brings 4000 as his share of goodwill by check, similar to the conditions of the previous problem. Here the additional information is old partners withdraw 50% of the premium credited to their accounts. Show how these transactions would appear in the books of accounts. So the amount brought in by the new partner is added to the bank account. So bank account, we are adding premium brought in by Sachin, 4000. Okay, and this 4000 must be distributed towards the old partners in their old ratio, in their sacrifice ratio. Here sacrifice ratio is equal to old ratio because the new ratio is not given. So we will divide 4000 in the ratio 5:3, 5/8 and 3/8 of 4000 will be 2500 and 1500. Now comes the second point to be done. Old partners withdraw 50% of the premium credited to their account. How much is credited to Sunil? 2500. So half of that he is going to withdraw. What is the entry for that? Old partners capital account debtor to bank account. So when partners withdraw goodwill amount credited, remember you are going to credit the bank account, not goodwill account, because amount goes out of your bank. Bank balance will decrease. So you will credit the bank account with the amount withdrawn by Sunil. How much he is withdrawing? He is withdrawing half of his amount. 2500 into half is 1250. Similarly, Dalip is withdrawing 1500, half of it. Half of this, that is 750. As 1250 and 750 are withdrawn by the partners, it will affect your bank balance. How? Bank balance will decrease. So you have to minus these two figures so that you get your new bank balance. So this is how we do when partners withdraw the premium brought in by the new partner. So please remember, when a new partner brings in goodwill in cash, that must be distributed among the old partners in their sacrifice ratio. And if the old partners withdraw this amount, it can be full amount, partial amount, you have to credit the bank account, not goodwill account. So let us take up this question. Srikanth and Raman are partners sharing in a firm, profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So 3:2 is their old ratio. This is their old ratio. They admit Venkat, new partner, for 1/3 share. The share of the new partner is 1/3, and he brings 30,000 as his capital. He also brings the necessary amount for his share of goodwill. The amount of goodwill to be brought in by the new partner is not given here. On the other hand, it is given. He brings goodwill. What is necessary? What is necessary is to be calculated. On the date of admission of goodwill is valued at ₹24,000. So on the date of admission, goodwill is valued at 24,000. So this is goodwill of the firm. This is not goodwill of the new partner. This 24,000 is the goodwill of Srikant, Raman, okay, and also the new partner Venkat now. So now we have to find out what is the amount, the necessary amount that Venkat has to bring in. How much amount he would have to bring in? Total goodwill of the firm is given 24,000. Srikant, Venkat's share is 1/3 of that. So he has to bring in 8,000 rupees. Now here there is one more adjustment given. A goodwill account appears in the books at ₹12,000. So please note that this has nothing to do with the value of goodwill, which is 24,000. So this 12,000 rupees, which is appearing in the books of accounts, must be written off. It should be written off into the capital accounts of the old partners. So Venkat brings in the necessary amount, it is repeatedly given again, towards his share, and agrees that existing goodwill must be written off. So 12,000 rupees we have to write off, we have to cancel it into the accounts of the old partners, and we have calculated the share of goodwill of Venkat, 8,000. He will bring, this is the necessary amount. So let us see how this will affect the accounts. Partners, a capital is given, capital is credited into his account, 30,000, which will increase the bank balance in the balance sheet. Bank account, you are adding capital brought by the new partner. Now, when we consider the value of goodwill, we found that goodwill is 8,000 rupees, and this is to be distributed in the ratio of sacrifice. Here the sacrifice ratio is not given, so we are considering at old ratio as the ratio of sacrifice. So we will divide 8,000 in the ratio of 3:2. So this 3:2 means 3/5, 8,000 into 3/5, 8,000 into 2/5. So you will get the amount of goodwill. Srikant's share is 4,800, Raman's share is 3,200. So this 8,000 rupees will increase your bank balance. 8,000 rupees increases the bank balance. Now, the partners are not withdrawing, but there is a 12,000 rupees goodwill which is already there in the books of the firm, which appears in the books of the firm, and this must be written off. This must be written off. What is the entry for that? The entry to write off goodwill is old partners capital account debtor in their old ratio to goodwill. So whenever goodwill is written off, old partners capital account must be debited and goodwill account must be cancelled. Goodwill account appears in the balance sheet means it is a debit balance, it is an asset debit balance, it is cancelled by crediting. And this should be done in the old ratio. What is the old ratio? 3:2. So when we divide 12,000 in 3:2, 3/5 and 2/5, we will get 7,200 and 4,800. So as goodwill is written off in the balance sheet, there will be no more goodwill account appearing. Goodwill account will not appear in the new balance sheet. Now, so far we have learned The treatment of goodwill can be of two types. It can be that the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash. We have seen how to record the transactions, how to record the journal entries, and how to post these entries into the ledger accounts. So if the goodwill is retained and also if goodwill is withdrawn, these two cases we have seen. Now let us see how to record, how to account if the new partner fails to bring his share of goodwill in cash. So there can be situations where a new partner says, I am able to bring only amount towards my capital, but I am not able to bring anything towards goodwill. So in that situation, how should we account it? When the new partner does not bring goodwill in cash, partly or fully, it should be debited to partner's current account. So the new partner's current account must be debited. Now there are two methods of maintaining capital accounts. Capital accounts may be maintained in fluctuating method, where all adjustments are recorded in the partner's capital accounts, or it can be maintained under fixed capital method, you have learned it, where adjustments comes in the partner's current account. Now in the new edition of NCERT textbook, which we follow, it is very specifically given, there is only one option. When the new partner does not bring his share of goodwill, it must be debited to the new partner's current account. The idea could be that current account will get wiped out when the new partner earns some profit during the year. At the same time, the old partners will be credited according to their sacrifice. So the journal entry for recording the amount of goodwill not brought in by the new partner is debiting the new partner's current account and crediting the old partner's capital accounts in the ratio of sacrifice. The old partners will be happy because they are getting the contribution, the premium amount towards the sacrifice they have done. The new partner's capital account will be kept intact. At the same time, his current account will be generated and that will show a debit balance, and he can settle that current account debit balance on a later date, or it will get wiped out when he gets his share of profit later on. And this looks more appropriate according to the accounting standard 26. We will see that also later on. Let us look at this question. Ajay and Uday are partners in a firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2. So 3:2 is the old ratio. They admit Martin, Martin is the new partner, into the firm for 1/3 share. This is the new partner's share of profits, which is equally contributed by old partners. So here it is very specifically given what is the sacrifice of old partners. There are two partners, Ajay and Uday. They are sacrificing, contributing equally. That means if Ajay has contributed one share, Uday also contributed one share. So 1:1 is the sacrifice ratio. So please note in this question, we are given sacrifice ratio. So as sacrifice ratio is given, we have to distribute the premium, the amount of goodwill, the share of goodwill of the new partner in the sacrifice ratio. It's very important in this question. Martin brings 50,000 as his capital. So this 50,000 we will credit in Martin's capital account by cash or bank. What about goodwill? He is unable to bring necessary amount for his share of goodwill. So here, the new partner is bringing 50,000, which is towards his capital, and he fails to bring, or he is unable to bring necessary amount towards goodwill. On admission, the goodwill is valued at 36,000. So this goodwill valued is of the firm. Goodwill of the firm is 36,000. What is the share of the new partner? 1/3. So we have to find out 1/3 of 36,000. That will be the share of the new partner, which comes to 12,000. So new partner is supposed to bring 12,000, which he is not able to bring. So what is the journal entry to record this? Of course, we have to debit new partner's current account according to the AS 26. The new partner's current account will be debited and old partner's capital account will be credited. So Ajay account and Uday account will be credited by Martin's current account. Okay, this is very, very important. The new partner's current account is debited and old partner's accounts are credited with 6,000 rupees each. Can you tell me how 6,000? Yes, 12,000 goodwill distributed in the ratio of sacrifice, which is 1:1. So 6,000 we have divided equally, half for Ajay and half for Uday. So 6,000 will appear in the columns of Ajay and Uday. Now this is only a book adjustment. There is no actual cash brought in by the new partner towards goodwill. So there will be no amount of goodwill added. No goodwill amount is added to the bank account. We are adding only the capital brought in by the new partner, Martin. There is nothing to be done regarding goodwill because the new partner is unable to bring goodwill. There will be no entry. Now, Martin's current account will show a debit balance. As it is a debit balance in the current account, it will appear on the asset side as a 12,000 unless it is wiped out by the profits of the firm. Accounting standard 26, it's connected with the intangible assets. It will be interesting to see the accounting standard on purchased goodwill. When a firm is acquiring another organization, it can result into purchase of goodwill. Okay, the value of the firm purchased, the new firm purchased, if it is more than the net assets of the firm, that will reflect that there is a goodwill in the firm. So when goodwill is purchased, it can be accounted. And if it is accounted in the books, it should be written off in the same year or not exceeding 10 years. So please note, in case of purchased goodwill, it may remain in the balance sheet. Okay, but it should be written off as soon as possible and it should not go more than 10 years. Whereas in case of self-generated goodwill, goodwill which arises out of the reputation of the business. Okay, what is done? The valuation of goodwill on admission of a partner, for example. This should be written off in the same financial year. It cannot be shown in the balance sheet as an asset. It should not be shown in the balance sheet as an asset. It should be written off. And this writing off is done by debiting the new partner's current account and crediting the old partners in their sacrifice ratio. So this justifies why we debit the new partner's capital account, new partner's current account. So this justifies why we debit new partner's current account when the new partner fails to bring his share of goodwill in cash. Let us look at this question. There is a problem given on the screen. Given below is the balance sheet of A and B. So A and B are the old partners who are carrying on partnership business as on March 31st, 2017. A and B share profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. So 2:1 is the old ratio. So you are given old ratio. Balance sheet shows bills payable, creditors, outstanding expenses, capitals of the partners. On the asset side, there is cash in hand and cash at bank. Sundry debtors, stock, plant and machinery, building. The total is 4 lakh each. It should tally. C is admitted as a partner on the date of the balance sheet in, on the following terms. C will bring his capital rupees 1 lakh and 60,000 as his share of goodwill for 1/4 share in profits. So the share of the new partner in profit is 1/4, 1/4. As his share, the new partner will bring 60,000 as his share of goodwill for 1/4 share in profits. So 1/4 share in profits is the share of the new partner. Plant and machinery is to be appreciated. Value of building is to be appreciated. So there are two assets which are appreciating. This will increase. This also will increase. Stock is found to be overvalued by 4,000, which means the value of stock given here, 40,000, is an overvalue. It is inflated figure. So that means we have to minus the amount we have valued extra. A provision for doubtful debts is to be created. There is no provision here. So we have to create a provision, which will mean our debtors will become less. 5% of the debtors. Creditors were unrecorded to the extent of 1,000. So our creditors, what is shown 58,000 is not the actual creditor. There is 1,000 not recorded. So the total creditors will be plus 1,000. Okay, these are the adjustments, prepare revaluation account, capital accounts and balance sheet. So we will open the revaluation account, capital accounts and the balance sheet. Now let us see how to solve this question. We will begin from the liability side. Bills payable, there is no adjustment. So we will just copy the bills payable here, 10,000 rupees. Sundry creditors are 58,000, but there is some adjustment. Adjustment number 5 says creditors were unrecorded to the extent of 1,000. So we have to add our creditors, 58,000 plus 1,000. So it will become 59,000. This increase in the liabilities is a loss to the business. So it should be debited in the revaluation account. All expenses and losses are to be debited. We are going to debit all losses. If there is any incomes or gains, that will be credited here on the credit side of the revaluation account. So we will, it is shown on the debit side of revaluation account, and that liability 1,000 is increased. The new creditors are 59,000. Now let us take up the next item. So bills payable, creditors, outstanding expenses, there is no adjustment. So we will just copy it. 2,000 rupees, we will write as it is, 2,000 in the balance sheet. Capital accounts are given on the liability side. All liabilities are credit balances. So capital account will be shown on the credit side of the capital accounts as balances. Capital of A, 1,80,000. Capital of B, 1,50,000. The same figures are taken and transferred to the credit side. Now let us go to the asset side. On the asset side, cash in hand, 10,000. We will do all the adjustments in the bank account. So we will write cash in hand as it is, 10,000. Cash at bank is 40,000. Okay, so cash at bank is 40,000. We can show this inside the trial balance sheet, or we can also show it as a separate account. In the working note, you can do it as a separate account. So 40,000 will be shown as a debit balance if you are showing it as a separate account. Then the capital brought in by the new partner, 1 lakh rupees, we are going to add to the 40,000 rupees. So we will add 1 lakh rupees. We will also add the goodwill amount brought in by the partner, 60,000. So 1 lakh plus 60,000 plus 40,000, the total bank balance will be 2 lakh. We will record the capital of the partner in the new partner's capital account, bank account debtor to new partner's capital. So new partner's capital is credited by bank. New partner's capital account is credited by bank. So bank account is credited. Capital account is credited. Now regarding the goodwill, 60,000 the new partner brings in. This is what we mean by premium. It should be distributed in the sacrifice ratio. What is the sacrifice ratio? It is not given. As sacrifice ratio is not given, we will consider it as equal to the old ratio. So 60,000 we will divide in the 2:1 ratio among the old partners. So we are distributing it in the sacrifice ratio, which is 2:1. So 60,000, when you divide 40,000 and 20,000, this goodwill amount is added here to the bank account. Now let us see that just other items. Sundry debtors, 60,000. There is an adjustment. Number 4 says a provision for doubtful debts is to be created at 5% of debtors. So 5% of the debtors, 60,000 into 5% you will calculate. That happens to be 3,000. And this is the provision for bad and doubtful debts. We are estimating about 3,000 rupees of the customers may not pay us. They may become bankrupt. So this is going to be a loss for the business. It will appear on the debit side, 3,000 rupees as a provision for bad and doubtful debts, which will mean our balance of the debtors will be less by 3,000 and it will be 57,000. So the sundry debtors balance will be now 57,000 after minusing provision for bad and doubtful debts. Now we have done the debtors. Let us go to the stock. Stock, there is an adjustment which we have to minus. 40,000 is the stock given. Out of this, 4,000 rupees stock is overvalued. So stock is found overvalued by 4,000. Means the 40,000 is not the real value of the stock. 4,000 is more in that. So ultimately we have to minus that. When we decrease our stock, it will result into a loss. So this loss is recorded on the debit side. Stock in hand 4,000, and this is a decreasing our asset. So from 40,000 we will minus 4,000, and the amount we are getting is 36,000. So that's how we will do stock. Now plant and machinery, there is an adjustment. Building, there is an adjustment. Both are to be appreciated. Plant and machinery appreciated to 1,20,000. So 1,20,000 is the new value of plant and machinery. That means it is increasing by 20,000. Your asset is increasing, which is a gain for the business. So as it is a gain, the increase 20,000 is shown on the credit side of the revaluation account, and this has to be added to our plant and machinery. So 1 lakh plus 20,000 is 1,20,000. 1 lakh plus 20,000. You can show it here. 1 lakh plus 20,000. Okay. Then the last item, building appreciated by 10%. So here 10% of the building we have to calculate. So 1,50,000 into 10%, which will amount into 15,000. This is also an increase, appreciation of your asset. It is a gain for your business. So you will show on the credit side of revaluation account 15,000, and this 15,000 we have to add. So 1,50,000 plus 15,000. Okay, you will show 1,65,000. Similarly, machinery will be 1,00,000 plus 20,000, 1,20,000. So all the assets we have considered now, we have taken capitals, we have written, okay, capitals are shown. So all the items of the liabilities and assets we have done. We will go through the adjustments to see whether there are any hidden items. Capital is written, share of goodwill is written, that is divided in the sacrifice ratio, which is old ratio. Then planned appreciation, building appreciation, stock overvalued, provision for doubtful debts, creditors unrecorded, everything is done. Now what is remaining is just balancing this account. Look at the revaluation account, the credit side is more, 35,000. So total the 35,000 should be written here also on the debit side. 35,000 minus the total of the debit, 4,000 plus 3,000 plus 1,000, 8,000. Okay, this is the profit on revaluation, which is to be divided among the partners in their old ratio, 2 upon 3 and 1 upon 3. So 27,000 into 2 upon 3 is 18,000, 27,000 into 1 upon 3 is 9,000. So 9,000 is the share of B. A will get 18,000 in the profit on revaluation, and this will increase their capital. So capitals will be credited by revaluation, 18,000 and 9,000. Then we will total all the credit side, 1,80,000 plus 40,000 plus 18,000. You get 2,38,000. 2,38,000 we will write on the debit side. There is nothing on the debit, so we will show the balance as the same. It is important to write the balance in the second last line, just above the total. You can show it here, the balances, instead of showing it on the first line. Then, similarly, we balance the account of B, 1,50,000 plus 20,000 plus 9,000, 1,79,000. The balance is the same amount, 1,79,000. 1 lakh is the capital account of C on the debit credit side. The same amount will come as balances. So balances of the partner A, B and C are found out. Here the credit side is more, so the balances will appear on the liability side. 2,38,000, 1,79,000 and 1 lakh. So the total capital is 5,17,000. Now when you add up the liabilities, you will get 5,88,000. Add up the assets, you will get 5,88,000. So students, this is how we will solve a problem on admission of a partner. You have to start from the liability side, doing one by one item. You will come to the asset side. As and you do each item, go through the additional information given, and there can be some revaluation adjustments. You can add or less, okay, in the balance sheet. If there is a gain, you will show on the credit side of revaluation. If it results in a loss, you will show on the debit side of revaluation. The profit on revaluation is transferred to only old partners' capital accounts in their old ratio. Now regarding goodwill, see whether it is a premium method, means if the partner is bringing cash for goodwill, then it should be recorded. The goodwill amount will be distributed among the partners in their sacrifice ratio. Very important to note this. If the new partner is not able to bring goodwill, the new partner's current account must be debited. Please keep that in mind according to AIS 26. Then you will balance the accounts. and transfer it ultimately to the balance sheet, and the balance sheet will tally. And when your balance sheet tallies, you feel happy. Thank you.
Prudent Scholars, powered by Lupin Pharmaceuticals.